handle the job situation. I think that's an issue that most American businesses are facing today, especially in our in the information technology industry. And we need to address creating jobs, keeping them here, and retooling people to do those new jobs. It's no secret in the information technology industry that most of the computer programming jobs are being exported overseas. And the estimate is it costs $56 an hour for a computer programmer in the US and $13 an hour in China. But we have to keep in mind that in the information technology business, there's always something new. And there are a lot of jobs in that regard if you have specialized skills in terms of governance, security, financial services. There are opportunities out there. So the answer really is in training. And my recommendation is that we need to take the existing funds that are being applied right now to all the job retraining programs, and we need to take those existing funds, create an oversight board where we make sure that we're retraining people for jobs that exist, and we keep retraining them. And the key point is that there be a focus on lifetime employability versus lifetime employment. And we've been doing that as a consulting firm with many large companies, but small companies need an incentive to do that, especially since small companies create 50% of the jobs, of the private sector jobs in the economy. Our consulting business specializes in using information technology to make boards of directors more effective. And so therefore we're pretty well versed in Sarbanes-Oxley Act. And this has become very costly and difficult to implement. So if I give you one very simple example, there is a portion where via Sarbanes-Oxley, employees who know of financial fraud going on within the company can contact the directors and let that be known. Well, many companies are implementing this by burying it within the same processes that they use for employee complaints and employee benefits and sex discrimination, and that's fine, except it doesn't really go along with the intent of the law, which is to detect the fraud, which is to create good corporate governance. So my point really is that the SEC needs to be aware of the importance of the integrity of the process involved. Because only if you have integrity of the process can you really create good corporate governance, and only then can that good corporate governance lead to investor protection.
What tax is most oppressive to your business?
Well, as a profitable business, the income tax is always the largest tax and has the largest effect.
In what way have the Republican Congress and White House benefited your business?
Well, by reducing the top tax rate as an S corporation, that in effect gives me more money to reinvest in my business.
Anything else you want to say?
The death tax should be permanently repealed, and it's just a totally inappropriate time to tax.
What tax is most oppressive to your business?
Tax that's most oppressive to business, and our business in particular, is the income tax. The rate is much too high, and we need overall tax reform to bring the tax laws into a perspective where people, one, can understand it, and secondly, to make our tax laws competitive with the rest of the world. If we have tax reform, we will be able to be more competitive, which would mean that jobs would not be going overseas quite as much. It's very, very important that tax reform be at the forefront, but it's a very difficult job, I understand that.
Should the death tax be permanently repealed, and why?
Yes, I believe the death tax should be permanently repealed. I think that most taxes have already been paid on the assets, and I do not believe that there should be a second tax instituted at the time of death. In order for many companies or people who own companies to pass those assets on to their beneficiaries, they either have to take out insurance in order to provide the cash to pay the tax, or they have to estate plan by selling the asset way before the time of death comes. It's an inappropriate time. Remember, the death tax was put into existence at a time when we did not have an income tax. It was a time when we had accumulation of enormous wealth by the Rockefellers, by the Carnegies, etc. It's a different time now than when the death tax was originally instituted. It's an inappropriate tax. It should be repealed.
Okay. Do you expect the economy to continue to grow at a record pace with the help of a Republican-led economic plan?
Yes, I do. I think that the economy will continue to grow. However, we must take into account the deficit. The deficit is going to have a retroactive effect on the economy. In other words, what's going to happen is that we're going to start to see a breaking of the economy because interest rates are going to start to go up. If we remember during the Vietnam War, we had enormous deficits. That will be a disaster for this country if interest rates spike. So we have to get the deficits under control. The way we would get the deficits under control, in my opinion, is through tax reform. And that's something that I would love to talk about with someone in Congress of how we can reform a tax system. Since I've practiced tax law for 32 years, and I know the system very, very well.
In what way have the Republican Congress and White House benefited your business?
My business has been benefited by the lower tax rate, by reducing the maximum tax rate for individuals from 38.6 down to 35%. That enabled us to take that extra money and invest it in our businesses. What that does is it provides not only additional employment, but it also provides money being spent in the economy to buy additional equipment, to procure additional services. In addition, by reducing the tax rate on capital gains as well as dividends, that has also enabled us to keep more of our money, which then can be plowed back into the economy to produce both jobs for third parties as well as jobs internally in my business.
Would you like to see the recent tax cuts expanded? And then to follow on that, would you like them to be made permanent?
Well, let me answer the second one first. I would like to see the tax cuts made permanent. However, to expand the tax cuts further means we're going to increase deficits. I think a better way of approaching that would be through tax reform, which would not necessarily have tax cuts, but we would change the method of taxation that we have. And that's something that, once again, I would love to discuss with some of my congressmen of tax reform and how we can make the system better.